Have you ever wondered how messages were sent before the invention of telephones? Let's wind back the clock to a time when communication was more, shall we say, rhythmic. A time when the world was introduced to a revolutionary way of sending messages, Morse code. This system of dots and dashes, longs and shorts, was the brainchild of two gentlemen named Samuel Morse and Alfred Vail. In the days of horse-drawn carriages and top hats, these two pioneers were busy creating a language that would forever change the course of history. Morse code became the heartbeat of communication, the rhythm of the telegraph, the pulse of information across vast distances. It was the dawn of a new era, an era where words transformed into patterns of sound and silence, traveling through wires and across oceans, connecting people in ways they never thought possible. So if we turn back the clock to the 19th century, we would be tapping out messages instead of typing them on our smartphones. But who were the masterminds that created this ingenious system of communication, you ask? Well, let's journey into the past to meet Samuel Morse and Alfred Vail, the architects of Morse code. Samuel Morse, a renowned painter and inventor, was the initial spark behind the idea. He was stirred into action after experiencing the pain of not being able to reach his dying wife in time due to slow communication. This motivated him to devise a faster way to transmit messages. Meanwhile, Alfred Vail, a skilled mechanic and inventor, was instrumental in refining Morse's telegraph machine and developing the dot and dash code. Vail's technical prowess complemented Morse's visionary ideas, creating a synergy that birthed the Morse code we know today. Their collaboration was a dance of brilliance, with each contributing unique strengths. Morse's passion and creativity met Vail's technical acumen, resulting in an invention that revolutionized global communication. So the next time you see a dot or a dash, remember the brilliant minds of Morse and Vail that brought us this innovative language. Now you might be thinking, how exactly did this Morse code work? Picture this, you're a 19th century telegraph operator. Morse code, a system of dots and dashes, represents each alphabet letter and digit. The code E is a dot and T a dash. To communicate, you tap these combinations on a telegraph key, transforming them into electrical signals. They'd travel along wires to another operator who decodes them back into characters. Ponder the thrill of receiving a message from afar, all couched in simple dots and dashes. You might be wondering, does Morse code still hold any relevance today? Well, the answer is a resounding yes. Morse code, once the backbone of global communication, has left a lasting legacy. Today it's not just a relic of the past, it's a living language, still used in certain areas of radio communication, particularly in the maritime world. Ships and coast guards around the globe use it as a universal language to send distress signals and safety messages. In the realm of amateur radio, Morse code is cherished as a classic mode of communication. It's a badge of honor among radio enthusiasts, a testament to their dedication and skill. And let's not forget its role in popular culture. From movies to music, Morse code has found its way into our hearts and minds, adding a touch of mystery and nostalgia. Morse code, a language of dots and dashes, continues to echo through time, reminding us of a bygone era of innovation and ingenuity.